Hello everyone, and welcome back to my studio. I was so happy when you fully supported my idea of making a complete collection of Disney princess dolls. So, we've made already Jasmine a couple of weeks ago, and today it's time for Snow White. And honestly, Snow White is probably my very favorite Disney princess of all. First of all, probably because I'm already quite an old lady, and Snow White was a legend even when I was a kid, when I was in this Disney princess age. So I'm really excited to make my own version of this doll today. And as a model for this transformation, I've decided to use this Frankie doll, because I really think that Frankie can become an ideal Snow White. So let's start probably. First of all, let's remove her outfit. Doesn't take long. Then the next step, we need to cut her hair as short as I can. Now I need to warm up her head to make this plastic soft to be able to remove the head, and also to melt the glue inside of the head to be able to pull off the rest of this short hair. Of course, many artists are using hot water for this, but please, I get comments about it absolutely every week that I should try hot water. I tried hot water and I absolutely have no idea why anyone in this world would do it. No, like, okay, I would use this hot water just in the case if my hair dryer got burnt or something, if it's broken, stolen, something like this. Because look, if I'm making the doll's head soft with a hair dryer, it takes me approximately 2 minutes in total here in the same place in my studio. I will take now this hair dryer, I will blow to this doll's head for about 2 maximum 3 minutes, and it will be done. If I'm going to use the soaking in hot water, I need to go to the kitchen, it will take a minute. Then I need to fill in the pot with water, it will take another minute. Then I need to wait till this pot with water cooks, it will take 3 minutes, 5 minutes, depends like on this kind of cooking plate in your house and on how big amount of water are you trying to cook. Then I need to soak this doll's head in this water. It also will take a while. You're not like putting it in and putting it out. You let it inside and you let it there also like for a minute, or at least for 30 seconds or something like this. Then it gets extremely hot. And I need to take really some towel or something to remove it, because I have a huge risk to burn myself with the steam, with this hot water. And then with this wet doll, I'm coming to my studio back 15 minutes later probably, where all the dry things are laying, pastels, pencils, everything. And I'm making here everything wet. Please, don't recommend me again to try to use hot water for removing doll heads and to plucking this hair out. Hair dryer works million times better, it's easier, it's safe, it's faster, and you don't need to run around with pots with cooking water here, there. Please, I have my hair dryer, I'm putting it on, and I'm blowing. 2 minutes, exactly. And here we are, exactly 2 minutes later. That's it. Why should you cook water? I don't know. So now I'm taking my tweezers and removing the rest of the hair from the inside of her head. After this, I'm going to take acetone and remove her original makeup. Our Snow White will have dark hair, of course, so now I'm going to cover her head with a couple of layers of black acrylics before I start rerouting her hair. Okay, now the paint looks dry to me and I can give her beautiful brand new hair using this original dark brunette Sarah that comes like always from Retro Dolls US web store. It will take of course a couple of hours like always, but this doll's hair is a little bit shorter than for example Jasmine's hair, and it's normal, Snow White's hair is shorter than Jasmine's hair, so I hope today it's going to go a little bit faster. When this job is done, I can add tacky glue inside of her head to fix all this new hair inside. Then I spread all this glue inside of the head with the Q-tips. And then I let the glue dry for sure for 24 hours. Okay, while the glue is drying, we can start working on her body. And first of all, I'm going to cut off this pin that we see in her neck. I don't think Snow White needs it very much. Then I'm going to sand her body like always using one of these nail buffers. When the glue inside of the doll's head dries completely, I'm going to clean it with acetone again, and the body I'm going to clean with an acetone-free nail polish remover. And never use pure acetone on these plastic doll bodies, otherwise you're going to simply melt them. So acetone for heads and acetone-free materials for bodies. And only like this. The Snow White's look is based of course on a very contrast combination of a very light skin, very dark hair and red lips. So to start, I'm going to cover the body and the face with a couple of layers of white acrylic paint using my airbrush. When I feel happy with the coverage of the white paint, I'm spraying the doll with 3 layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant to prepare the surface for drawing on it. Okay, now my white canvas is ready and I can start working on her face, and I have prepared here already a bunch of pencils and pastels, and you can see that all of them have very natural light color. As a palette for my pastels, I'm using like always a piece of sanding paper, yeah, and the brushes I have shown you already in my last video a week ago. So I think we can start, and first of all I'm going to sketch her eyes and eyebrows. I have here a reference picture with me on my phone, but I don't know if it's going to help me that much because, you know, it's a typical cartoonish Disney drawing. But anyway, at least to see the shape of her eyes, how the eyebrows are placed, yeah, the eye color, things like this might be helpful. Now also let's draw the nostrils and the line between her lips, and after this I can move to blushing her face because we still have to create some more realistic and normal looking skin tone. So I'm starting with very light nude pink pastels. But I'm planning to apply 2 or 3 layers of these pastels, and it will give me really beautiful, very light and very natural kinds of a shadow on her face, because I don't want her to look, you know, too tanned. It's Snow White. And then I'm going to protect this layer with Mr. Super Clear sealant, of course. Then I'm applying the next layer of shadows using exactly the same pastels, and this layer I again protect with the sealant, and then we'll see, maybe we'll have to repeat it one more time to reach a nice coverage. So this is how her face looks after applying 3 layers of these light nude pink pastels. And now I'm going to work some more detail on her eyelids, her nose and the lip area using my pencils. And I use Faber-Castell Albrecht Dürer pencils and also Caran d'Ache Supercolor soft pencils. Both of them are watercolor and it's quite essential because if you work with regular pencils and combine it with this Mr. Super Clear Serum and with this rubber doll face, after a year or so, maybe a year and a half, maybe after 2 years, your doll face is going to become yellow because regular pencils, they contain oils, and these oils, yeah, of course, they give reaction when they come together with rubber and also with the sealant. She's always sitting here on the closet right above me and checking me out. I blend this pencil nicely with Q-tips and then I add a touch of a little bit darker pastels on top of it. And then I set all these powders with the sealant again. Now I think her face still misses a touch of blush. It would make her face to look much more healthy and radiant, you know, because now it looks quite sepia style. And then I set all the powders with a layer of the sealant again. Okay, now I think I'm pretty happy with her skin color. It looks very snow whitish to me. So I can take my pencils and work more detailed on her eyes, eyebrows, lips and all other features. And I will start like always with the white of her eyes. The eyes are going to be brown this time because this is what we see on the reference picture here. And if we take a look again at the reference picture, we will see that Snow White has obviously red lips. So let's draw them. Okay, now I think I'm ready to protect this layer with the sealant and then I'm going to repeat it again off camera probably because I just want to reach a little bit better coverage of all these pencils. And this is how her color looks after applying 3 layers of these basic colors. But of course now it looks quite flat and not realistic at all. So I'm going to start working on it more detailed, applying shadows, highlights and making it all look more realistic and 3-dimensional. And I start like always with applying shadows to the white of her eyes. Then I draw more detail the irises and the waterline. Now let's add highlights to the eyelids. And I also keep working on her eyebrows, of course. And of course I need to draw some shadows and highlights around her lips as well. Okay, now I can protect this layer with the sealant and then I'm going to apply it all again, repeat this layer completely because of course the biggest part of these highlights of this light pencil is going to disappear after I apply the sealant. Yeah, you can see it now. The light colors have been gone for a big part, so now I'm refreshing it again. And also in the end of this layer, I'm going to draw the bottom eyelashes and also some smaller details using a very sharp black pencil, like the eyeliner, maybe the pupils, a little bit the eyebrows. And you know what? I think she still looks a little bit pale to me. I think I want to add a little bit extra blush to her cheeks, and it's very important to blend it nicely. So I'm going to use even the Q-tips. I've protected my work with two layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant, and now I'm going to add the brightest accents, the highlights to her eyes, using this very, very, very fine brush and a tiny drop of white acrylic paint. Okay, now let's take a look at her body, and this is how it looks next to the face. Yeah, very satisfying like always. I think we've done a really nice job today. But now I'm going to blush her body using exactly the same pastels I used for her face, because of course her face and her body should better be the same color. Now I think I can connect the head and the body back together, and then we're going to style her hair. You know, the Snow White's original hairstyle is not that much detail drawn in the original cartoon. And that's why probably you can find really numerous variations and options of this hairstyle online. Really, people do all kinds of things, and long hair their style in some way, like rolling hair, making it look short. And some people style their original short hair in some curly way. So that's why I feel kind of free to create my own version of this hairstyle. But first of all, of course, we have to make this hair lay flat, because right now you see they're just staying kind of straight, 90 degrees. Most of the doll artists use hot wash for it, you know it of course, and you know it of course already that I don't like water in my studio. That's why I'm going to use my hair dryer like always to make her hair completely flat. Okay, how I'm going to do it? I've splitted her hair in three parts. You see here are small ones on the front and the rest of the hair on the back. I brush her hair nicely, and then I make a very low ponytail on the back. And then I'm kind of rolling her hair up. See, this is what I've got. Then I take a couple of pins and I fix this hairstyle with pins. Yeah, looks pretty good, I think. Then I take this hair from the front and I connect them to this hair on the back from both sides. I like wrap it around in some way, like this. And then I also fix it with another elastic. And now when I finally feel happy with her hairstyle, I can attach the false lashes and apply glossy varnish to her eyes and lips. I've asked my mom to recreate the iconic Snow White's outfit, and here is her short work in progress video. And this is how the end result looks. I think it's just another masterpiece from my mom. This fabric, I think, yes, it's another natural silk. This is another piece of real silk. There's some lace. Everything's just exactly like on the reference picture. Here I have also a bow to decorate her hairstyle. Her look I'm going to complete with these yellow shoes. And now I think it's time to put everything on our doll and take a look at the end result pictures. So this is my Snow White, and this time I'm especially happy with her skin tone, because I remember when I repainted the Snow White from Hasbro, I've got lots of comments saying she was too tanned. So this time she's for sure 100% real Snow White. But I bet there will be lots of comments who will come here and will anyway call her too pale, but it's internet, you know, there's nothing to do about it. Her outfit and hairstyle are also very adorable to my taste, but what do you think? Let's discuss it in the comments. But there is even more important question: who should I make next? Which Disney princess? I've planned nothing yet, just reserved a place for a Disney princess doll in my schedule, and I'm completely open for different options, so let's vote for the next one in the comments. And this doll will be like always available for sale on eBay for 3 days, so the link will be in the description box. And now let's also make an instant picture of this doll like always to decorate my whiteboard. I really hope, guys, you've enjoyed this makeover today, and if so, please don't forget to support my channel and my art with your likes. And also, of course, don't forget to check if you already subscribed to my channel, and also hit the bell button. And I will see you already very soon, next week Friday. Have a fantastic weekend, guys. Love you. Bye.